I was hanging out with my friend Unirock on one of his live streams when the topic of the Montauk project came up. And since I've always wanted to be a time traveler, I wanted to know everything about it. And here's what I learned. This is a series where I tell you a story, its subsequent theories and explanations, and then I'll let you make up your mind. This time we're delving into a conspiracy theory that doesn't just cover one topic, the Montauk Project. Sometime in the 50s, the surviving researchers of a project called Rainbow, better known as the Philadelphia Experiment, got together and thought it was a good idea to just continue the project. I have a video up about the Philadelphia experiment. A link will be put at the end of this vid. But suffice it to say, it involved manipulating an electromagnetic bottle to make the USS Eldridge invisible. Oh, I can't wait to disappear. Promising a powerful new weapon that could drive people crazy at the flick of a switch, a proposal was made to the United States Department of Defense. Without congressional approval, they deemed it too dangerous. Secret funding was found in the form of $10 billion worth of Nazi gold found in a train in a tunnel somewhere in France. The train was allegedly blown up together with the soldiers who found it. When these ran out of additional funds were secured from ITT and Krupp AG in Germany. The mystery of the Nazi gold solved. You heard it first on my channel. Well, not really, because I got it from a web page. Oh well. Not long into the project, the Brooklyn Haven National Laboratory in Long Island was abandoned for an abandoned US Air Force base at Montauk, New York. Because they had the semi-automatic ground environment or SAGE radar installation they needed ready and waiting there. On top of that, the Montauk base was large and remote, and water access would allow equipment to be moved in and out undetected. An underground bunker was installed at Camp Hero, and in 1969 they closed down the facility and made it into a wildlife refuge park, with the condition that the military could keep using the underground bunker. Although allegedly, the base was kept in operation until 1980. Get your facts straight, dudes. The conspiracy theory began when Preston B. Nichols came forward and told he had been an electrical engineer working for the project. He got pulled into the Mind Sciences program at Montauk. He claimed they used what they called the Montauk Chair, which used subtle quantum fields to read people's minds, and through a group of coils and radio receivers, the later allegedly designed by Tesla, were digitalized into computer code, and the radar was used to turn them into reality. Get me that chair and I'll turn the world into a better place. Yes, I will. Things got out of hand when a creature washed up at a beach named the Montauk Monster. But this incident deserves a whole vid on its own. A lot supposedly went on there. The facility supposedly was extended to 12 levels, with hundreds of workers, and even reached under the town of Montauk. Nazi scientists from the Project Paperclip were involved, and the before mentioned Nikola Tesla's death was faked to make him director of operations. And if this doesn't raise your eyebrow, just wait until I tell you what they did. Homeless people were abducted and subjected to high amounts of electromagnetic radiations. Psychic abilities were enhanced. Experiments in teleportation were done. A stable time tunnel was built. Mind control and psi warriors like Men in Black were created. Metahumans and special serums were tested. The Jersey Devil was created. A hole to the Earth's core is hidden there. Work on the internet started there. Black helicopters were manufactured and flown. And the AIDS virus was created there. Oh yeah, and one more thing. The scientists allegedly sent representatives over to the USS Eldridge to shut down their reactors so they would return to Philadelphia. They had their work cut out for them. Okay, we're not done yet. I kept the best for last. Our old friends the aliens were contacted and technology was exchanged, which allowed them to broaden access to the hyperspace. Then an alien monster came through that destroyed equipment and ate some researchers. Yummy! Resulting in the shutdown of the time tunnel and the destruction of the monster. Why wasn't I invited to that party? All the evidence is circumstantial, say the skeptics. Furthermore, the building of a 12-level facility underground would have left clues, yet nobody saw building materials being brought in, nor was there a single bulldozer seen. To the skeptics' knowledge, the hundreds or thousands, according to the Iron Skeptic, of people working in the labs were never replenished with supplies like food and toilet paper. They also say that the equipment costs hundreds of millions, especially the particle accelerator that is supposedly housed there. Moreover, that accelerator would be miles in diameter. The skeptics also claim that the conspiracy theorists use a mishmash of scientific terms that are in the end meaningless. Well, it's not because you don't understand it that it is meaningless. So why was the facility closed but not demolished? If not because of the valuable equipment that supposedly is not there. First of all, the lone island boaters like it because it is bigger than the relatively tiny lighthouse. And it has historical value, as it is the only surviving SAGE radar system in the world. There are supposedly plans to turn it into a museum specializing in the Cold War, and during its preparations, no subterranean bases have been uncovered. Like they would make it easy to find them, bro. Doesn't the saying go, where there is smoke, there is fire? Is really nothing going on there? Or is at least something happening anyway? You decide. If you like this vid, slap a like on it. Share. Leave comments in the box below. Or subscribe if you want to see more. I have a vlog channel you might want to check out. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.